The area you are now in is a coastal region, but just behind, inland, are the mountains. On your way to explore the mountains, you'll find some little gems. Rivers that look as black as coal, due to the leaching of iron from the rocks. And a piece of forest that is a must, because it's the home of the big tree. And when we say big, we mean huge. Even our camera couldn't find the top of it. The major pass through the mountains here is on a dirt road which is kept in good condition. It's called the Montague Pass. It'll take about 2 hours to drive the pass through the mountains to George, so it's probably a better idea just to go to the foot of the pass and admire the breathtaking view. Seeing this area aboard a train is another experience altogether. The George to Knysna Choo-Choo is highly recommended as the railway passes areas inaccessible by road and the scenery is often quite spectacular. Most of the garden route is overlooked by the Otoniqua Mountains. Various passes cross the mountains and are worth travelling for the scenic pleasures. The old road between George and Knysna, still in use, offers an 82-kilometre very beautiful scenic drive known as the Passes Route. It links various small settlements and forest stations. There are also numbers of lesser-known passes to cross, which will definitely enhance your visit to the garden route area. If you're a golfer, then, in the garden route area, you'll be spoiled for choice. There are over 20 courses between Mossel Bay and Plett, and many of them are within very close proximity to George. The countryside around George, which is the largest city and virtual capital of the garden route region, is full of pleasant surprises. Visit the Garden Route Botanical Gardens to view the amazing range and beauty of the indigenous plants of the region. George Dam is a popular picnic spot. Berry farming is popular, as can be experienced with a visit to Redberry Farm, a leading strawberry farm with a wonderful deli on its premises. And this area is the only area in South Africa where hops are grown successfully. Here they are harvested, stripped, sorted. Hops are mainly used in the brewing of beer. George Airport is the only airport in the region capable of handling big passenger jets, so it's the only place to fly to from the major centres of Cape Town, Johannesburg and Durban. It is serviced by daily flights. As it is the regional capital, George is well supplied with a great array of shops. There is a new international shopping mall opened just outside the town. And the main shopping area in town offers all the big-name retailers of South Africa and some excellent local alternatives. For sightseers, there are numerous beautiful old buildings, churches, and two outstanding museums. The George Museum and the Otoniqua Railway Museum, where you can see some fine examples of the heydays of the steam locomotive.